Elton John is
authentic, colorful.
I think he's a genius.
Hilarious.
Been a great father.
Icon.
Philanthropist.
It's impossible to describe Elton in a few words.
Jean King interview, take one.
Take one.
Elton John is endearing.
He's fun. He's competitive. He's intense.
He seems to get what it's like to be a real person.
His voice and his name alone has empowered people to live their authentic life and be their authentic self.
Elton John's impact is generational.
I've always felt like Elton was my guardian angel, so to speak.
Elton John was an amazing example of somebody who came out and was fearless about it.
It really gave so many kids inspiration and hope.
His heart is huge. He's just so caring.
The way that he bridges his art with his story is his superpower.
Elton John is one of those few people that defies demographic.
He has made the world a better place for people to navigate the earth, regardless of gender, identity, race, financial status. No one's left behind.
Are there any other memories or stories?
Yeah, I'd like to share one with you. During the last few days of Ryan's life, Ryan became very ill. He was in the hospital for a couple months. I looked over at Elton and he had tears just running down his face. I went over and put my arm around him and I said, "What's the matter?" He said, "You know, with all the money that's in this room, we can't bring this boy back to life." It was a real realization to Elton at that time. He had everything. He had everything he could ever want, but he didn't have his health. I think that that dwelled on him so much that that's why he went and got help, went into rehab.
Elton feels like he's got a second chance. He promised himself he would just give back the rest of his life.
In September of 2019, my husband heard about the Elton John Yellow Brick Road concert and decided we should go. And then COVID hit and the concert was, of course, postponed. Fast forward several months later, my husband came down with COVID. And on December 8th of 2020, he passed away. Never having the opportunity to go to the concert. When the concert was rescheduled, I wasn't sure that I could go, but Jeanette said, "Come on, we got to do it for Dad." And I felt my husband's presence there with us that night. Elton was such an inspiration, listening to his music.
The music, it's about love and it's about hope. And no matter where you are, what generation you are, that's always relevant.
Well, first of all, Elton's legacy is not finished.
You know, we talk about transcending generations. That was what he's so good at, and he's still doing it.
He's like this big celebrity, but to us, he's our friend.
That fool was wearing a Donald Duck outfit, standing on top of a piano in the 1970s, and he has not stopped. For Elton's 75th birthday, he wrote a letter to his sons where he explained the importance of being a man, giving back to the world. It's an amazing letter.
But honestly, it could be an open letter to the world.
I could have never dreamed where life would take me.
I was told to fit in, do what others expected,
even when it didn't feel right.
Whoever you grow up to be, just be you.
Just be you.
Just be you.
Just be you.
Fully and completely you.
Build bridges, not walls.
Most people, gay, straight, black, white, rich or poor,
all want to be safe, respected, loved, and free.
I've seen how we can make progress by acknowledging our differences
and learning how to have compassion and empathy for each other.
Give back.
This world is unequal and unfair.
It's on us to make it better.
By opening a dialogue, we have opened our hearts and minds.
Be yourself.
Be yourself.
Be yourself.
Push the envelope a bit.
And ruffle some feathers where you need to.
Remember what unites us.
What unites us.
What unites us
is far greater than what divides us. I hope you don't mind.
I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in the world.
I can't thank him enough for all he's done and how he wants to make this world a better place and how much he's given and continues to give. You know what? Are you still going? Mm-hmm. Elton always wanted to live like a legend, and he died.
Elton John.
What a dump. I've played in some places before that have been beautiful, but this is probably the icing on the cake. And I want to thank everybody who asked me to play tonight. I don't know how to take a compliment very well, but it's wonderful to be here amongst so many people who have helped my AIDS Foundation and my heroes, the ones that work day to day on the front line. Teachers, nurses, everybody who's helped. They're the heroes to me. God bless you. Let's have some music. It does bring us together.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money. Boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is while you're in the world. Sat on the roof and kicked up the moss with a few of the verses. Oh, they got me quite cross. But the sun's been quite kind. Well, I've wrote that song. Oh, it's for people like you that keep it turned on. So excuse me for getting, but these things I do. You see, I forgot if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is what I really mean. Oh, yours are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. You can tell everybody that's your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is while you're in the world. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is while you're in the world. Thank you so much. Alan, could you make my voice a little sharper? It's a bit muffled. Thank you. God seen in me, I played with me, tied a dance in my hand. Oh, how it really feels like here with no one there, only you, and you can hear me when I say it softly, slow. She packed my bags last night, pre-flight, 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space. I'm such a timeless flight. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Touchdown brings me around again to find I'm not the man that they got home. I'm a rocket man, rocket man, burning out his fuse up hell alone. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Till touchdown brings me around again to find I'm not the man that think I'm at home. Oh, I'm a rocket man, rocket man, burning out his fuse up here alone. Bars ain't the kind of place to raise your kids. Facts as cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them up if you did. And all the science I don't understand, it's just my job 5 days a week. Rocket man. think you're gonna be a long, long time. So touchdown, bring the spear on a kill to find. I'm not the man that think I'm at home. I'm a rocket man, rocket man, burning out his fuse up there. I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me around again to fight. I'm not the man that think I am at home. Oh, rocket man, rocket man, burning out his fuse up here below. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. I think it's gonna be a long, long time. It's gonna be a long, long time. It's gonna be a long, long time.
I've been involved in fighting AIDS since 1991, and it was a pretty grim situation back then. And the reason that I got involved in AIDS is because years before that, I met Ryan White, and I met his family. I met Jeannie and Andrea, his sister, And I got to love them and look at them. And they faced such terrible hostility and hatred. And yet, when Ryan was dying in the hospital in Indianapolis, the last week of his life, where I went and tried to help Jeannie do menial things, there was no hatred from Jeannie. There was no hatred from Andrea. There was just forgiveness. And I thought to myself, this is incredible. I would be so full of hate. And I went back to my hotel room and I thought, these people are real Christians. They have everything, but they have nothing. The everything is what I wanted, because they had faith. And I would go back to a hotel room and complain about the wallpaper and the furniture. And I thought, you know, your life is pretty messed up here. 6 months after Ryan passed, I got sober and clean. And if it wasn't for Jeannie and Ryan and Andrea, I wouldn't be here talking tonight. They saved my life. They showed me that there's a better way of forgiveness, love, kindness. And I truly mean this from the bottom of my heart. Jeannie White is an absolute saint. I adore her. And Ryan, you saved my life. Thank you so much. I want to dedicate this song to them. They are inspirational people, like all of you out there. I can't lie no more of your darkness. All my pictures seem to fade to black and white. I'm growing tired. Time stands still before me. Frozen here on the ladder of my life. It's too late to save myself from falling. Took a chance and changed your way of life. But you misread my meaning when I begged you. Close the door. You left me blinded by the light. Don't let the sun go down on me. Although I'd search myself, so if someone else I'd see, I'd just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. Losing everything is like the sun going down on me. I can't find. See me walk and see the way.
to scar. Just forgot to bang him in your horn. But these cuts are here. They need love to help my beer. Don't let the sun go down on me. Although I search myself, so if someone else I see, I just allow a segment of your life to wander free. Just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. But losing everything is like the sun going down on me. But losing everything is like the sun going down on me.
I've been to Washington quite a lot. I've been to an AIDS conference here, World AIDS conference. I've been to the Senate, I've been to Congress to lobby for money, and they've always come through. And it's to all credit to America that they have led the way in funding the fight against HIV and AIDS. And it's never ceases to amaze me the generosity of the American people and the American government. And looking at First Lady Laura Bush over there, I remember when I came to get the Kennedy Center Award, and I had the most fantastic conversation with President Bush backstage at the interval. And he said, get the French. I said, is there anything? He said, is there anything I can do? And he said, yes, get the French to give more fucking money. And the AIDS epidemic in America has always been a bipartisan thing. One of the few things, probably the only thing left at this time, is on both sides, money comes from AIDS. I can't tell you how many times I've rung Lindsey Graham, but it's quite a few times, and to his credit, he's always come through. But I want to say to the First Lady, President Bush accelerated the whole thing with his PEPFAR bill. It was the most incredible thing. We would never have got this far without the President Bush administration giving us that money. So please tell him from me, give him a big hug. It was an astonishing moment in the fight against HIV and AIDS. And I just wish America could be more bipartisan on everything, but you know, what can you do? Now, A little person whispered in my ear, well, not a little person, a grown-up, and said, this particular song meant something to the president when he used to drive his kids to school. And I can't imagine him singing it, but I might get him up here to join me in a minute, but I won't, actually. So, I remember when Rock was young, me and Susie had so much fun, holding hands and skimming stones. Had an old gold Chevy, a place of my own, but the biggest kick I ever got was done to thank God the Crocodile Rock, while the other kids were rocking around the clock. We were hopping and bopping to the Crocodile Rock. Well, try rocking, stop the chop, and then your feet up, and keep still. I never knew me a better time, and I guess I never will. Light a bottle on Friday nights, Susie Walker gets it tight, and Crocodile Rock was dying out of sight. For some foreign guy, long nights crying by the wrecking machine, dreaming of a sailor, my old routines, let them never kill the thrill we got. Running up to the Crocodile Rock, learning fast as the weeks went by. Really thought the Crocodile Rock would last well. Try rocking, stop the jump, and then your feet up, thank you. Never will. Light a mama, Friday nights, Susie Walker, death is tight. Crocodile Rock was dying out of sight. All right. I can't tell you what it means to me to be here and being a guest of honor tonight to play to you people. I honestly take my advocacy and my philanthropy seriously, but you know, I don't think I'm the great be end and all end of things, because I'm not on the front line, as I said earlier. But my dear hope, and I would like to thank Anne Aslett and David Furnish, my husband, from my foundation, for being behind me 100% and doing the most amazing job to end AIDS by 2030. We can do it.
We can do it. And we will do it, okay? We will do it. I, of course, by that time will be 83. But I'll still be fighting. I will not stop fighting for people who have passed away, sometimes in the most painful circumstances, the people who died to get America and the world off its ass and do something about this terrible disease. So we've made a lot of progress. We've made a lot, but we have to get rid of the stigma. But we won't take, I won't take my foot off the accelerator ever. And I know that most people in this room will join me and say they won't take their foot off the accelerator either. People need hope, they need dignified lives, they need love and care, and people to know that if you're even in another continent, people feel loved and know there's someone over somewhere else that is caring about them. That is so important. Love and care to people who need it. You go to Africa and you see what happens to people when they feel love and hope and they're given a reason to live. It's the best feeling in the world. So thank you all for being so generous to me tonight. Mr. President, Dr. Biden, I won't forget this night ever. It's just an amazing, for me being English or British or whatever. What can I say? But thank you a million times over. And for everybody here who came tonight, let's keep the fight. Let's keep the fight on, okay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Tonight, it's my great honor, and I mean this sincerely, to present the National Humanities Medal to Sir Elton John. Major Yang, please read the citation.
Honored, sir. Good evening, everyone. The President of the United States awards this National Humanities Medal to Sir Elton John for moving our souls with his powerful voice and one of the defining songbooks of all time. An enduring icon and advocate with absolute courage, who found purpose to challenge convention, shatter stigma, and advance the simple truth that everyone deserves to be treated with dignity and respect.
I think we surprised him.
I just said to the First Lady, I'm never flabbergasted, but I'm flabbergasted and humbled and honored by this incredible award from the United States of America. I will treasure this so much, and it will make me double my efforts to make sure this disease goes away. Your kindness, America's kindness to me as a musician, is second to none. But in the war against AIDS and HIV, it's even bigger. And I can't thank you enough. I'm really emotional about this. Thank you.
And by the way, it's all his fault that we're spending $6 billion in taxpayer money this month to help AIDS fight HIV/AIDS. Hello, hello, hello. This is David, his husband. I'm sure he's easy, no problem, right? None. Anyway, we're gonna get a picture. Come on, David, get in. Enjoy the evening, everyone. We're not over yet.